Hey tech enthusiasts, welcome back to our channel, FASTCABLING. So have you ever wondered how your devices communicate wirelessly over long distances? Today in this video, we are going to unravel the mysteries of wireless bridge in just 5 minutes. So wireless bridges serve as a pivotal component in network connectivity by wirelessly linking two separate networks together and providing a seamless and efficient communication pathway. They're devices that connect and extend network without the need for physical cabling. So wireless bridges facilitate the exchange of data between geographically separated locations. These bridges operate by utilizing common frequency bands, such as the widely used 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz spectrums, allowing for reliable data transmission over the airwaves. And in a point-to-point wireless bridge setup, two distinct locations are directly connected, forming a dedicated link. And conversely, when a point-to-multipoint configuration enables the connection of one central location to multiple points simultaneously. And this versatility makes the wireless bridge a flexible solution for diverse networking needs, offering a reliable and wire-free means of interconnecting network and enhancing the overall connectivity efficiency. And creating a robust and effective wireless bridge setup involves several essential components. First, antennas. They are the fundamental elements responsible for transmitting and receiving signal, enabling the wireless bridge to establish a reliable link between two distinct points. And the choice of antenna is critical, considering factors such as signal strength, directionality, and the specific requirements of the bridge setup. And radios. Radios contribute and other integral components, serving as the core of the wireless communication process. This radio operates within specific frequency bands such as the 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz, facilitating the transmission of data over the airwaves. And the efficiency and performance of the wireless bridge heavily depend on the quality and capability of the radio employed. Last but not least, the Ethernet port complete the bridge setup by providing physical connection for the devices to link with the bridge. This port allows seamless integration of wired devices into the wireless network and offering flexibility and versatility in network configuration. So by connecting devices using the Ethernet port, the wireless bridge can ensure a reliable and stable connection, accommodating various network needs and facilitating the smooth exchange of data between connected devices. And wireless bridges offer versatile solutions across various use cases, enhancing the network functionality and connectivity. Firstly, they excel in extending network coverage, enabling businesses to broaden their reach without the constraint of physical cabling. Connecting remote offices becomes seamless with wireless bridge, fostering efficient communication and collaboration. And in challenging terrain where traditional connectivity method might be impractical, wireless bridge can bridge the network together, overcoming geographic obstacles. And in a wireless bridge setup, speed and range consideration are paramount, with factors such as frequency band, interference, and signal strength can influence the performance. And tips for maximizing wireless bridge performance include optimizing antenna placement, selecting suitable frequency bands, and minimizing interference. So next, I'm going to show you how to set up a wireless bridge connection. As you can see on the monitor, this is a live video. But where's the camera? It's actually all the way across the room over there, connected with the other wireless bridge. So coming over this side, we have another bridge here. and we are going to use this bridge to finish the connection. Now, this is a complete system to set up a high-speed wireless network connection that requires long-distance transmission range fast and easily, and also compliant with 802.11a and ANNAC Wi-Fi standard. You are able to set up a wireless connection at a maximum of 900 megabit per second transmission rate within 3 kilometers transmission range with no obstacle in between. Moreover, this wireless bridge also offers plug-and-play connection, and you can match the wavelength of each bridge easily just by pressing a single button without complicated configuration on the wrap. And with the waterproof and weatherproof design and certified IP67 protection, this stable wireless connection is available even under outdoor or industrial harsh environment. So without saying, let's do the connection together. So our router is already connected to the network video recorder. All we need to do is use another Ethernet cable to connect the router directly to our wireless bridge. So coming over here, I'm going to power up our wireless bridge using 12 volt DC. And then this is the Ethernet cable from the router. Let's connect it with the bridge. As you can see here, we have a reset button. We're going to press this button to change the channel in order to match with the other wireless bridge. And make sure, and the M and S mode, make sure you tilt it to the M mode. So now I'm going to go to the back of the wireless bridge. The red one here is actually the channel number. I'm going to use the button now, the reset button. I'm going to press it so it will change the channel. Now it's on channel 2. Let's put it back facing to the other wireless bridge. So we're coming this side to the another wireless bridge that is connected to the IP camera. As you can see, it is already powered up. All we need to do is going to the back of the bridge. Again, press the button to channel 212. Facing it to the other wireless bridge. Use a short patch cord to connect the bridge and the camera. And the camera is already powered up, so let's give it a minute. Coming over to the monitor, you can see this is absolutely a live video, which is the same camera that connected to our wireless bridge. So sometimes we may have a lot of questions about the wireless bridges, and here one of the questions that you may ask. Can we use wireless bridge for home networks, or are they just for businesses? Well, absolutely, wireless bridges can be utilized for home network as well, and they are not exclusive to businesses. Wireless bridge provide a flexible and convenient solution for extending network connectivity within a home environment too. And they can be employed to connect various devices, such as your smart TV, gaming consoles, or computers, especially in situations where running physical cables is impractical or aesthetically undesirable. So another question, is a wireless bridge compatible with any IP cameras or SS point? Now, the compatibility of a wireless bridge with IP cameras or SS point largely depend on the standard and protocol that they support. In general, many wireless bridges are designed to work with standard networking equipment, including a wide range of IP cameras and SS point. But before the implementation, it is advisable to check the product's documents and specification to guarantee interoperability between the wireless bridge and your specific IP cameras or SS point that you intend to use. So last questions, Do weather conditions affect wireless bridge performance? The answer is yes. Weather conditions can indeed impact the performance of wireless bridges. Various weather elements such as rain, snow, fog, and extreme temperatures can introduce challenges to wireless communication. Thick fog and heavy rain might further attenuate signal, affecting the overall signal strength and reliability of the wireless bridge connection. Additionally, extreme temperature can influence the efficiency of electronic components, so it is crucial to consider these factors when deploying the wireless bridge, especially in outdoor setting. And to mitigate the impacts of weather conditions, a proper equipment selection, including the weather-resistant enclosure, can help maintain the optimal performance. So that's all for today. Thank you very much for joining us. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment below and we can start our conversation now. And I'll see you in the next video.